Yo, what's up? Dr. Swole here, MD, bodybuilder, back with another video. So I got asked a question by Andrew, who's actually a doctor based in New Jersey, who asked me how to navigate pre-workout nutrition when you have a busy schedule. So that's what our video today is going to be about. I think there are a lot of misconceptions about peri-workout nutrition, so we'll clear some of those up today. So when we're thinking about what to eat before a workout, our main priorities are going to be one, we want to promote muscle protein synthesis. That's obvious. Two, we want to optimize our training performance in the gym. Three, not puke. I think this is an underrated one, but digestion definitely plays a big role and is important for us to consider. Four, we want to be flexible. I think that having an approach to nutrition that is not only optimal for results, but also is maximally flexible, is really important for bodybuilding to fit into your life and be sustainable over the long term. Quick outline for today. First of all, we're going to talk about the role of each nutrient in pre-workout nutrition as it pertains to maximizing muscle growth. The nutrients we're going to want to consider in this case are protein, carbohydrates, fats, and fiber. As we go through each nutrient, we'll be looking at the science and practical considerations that we need to think about when designing our pre-workout meals. Lastly, we'll put all of this together and give you my recommendations for the best pre-workout meal to build muscle. If that sounds good to you, smash that like button, hit subscribe, and let's get right into it. Okay, so the first most important nutrient we're going to talk about is protein. Now, protein has a couple of main roles. First of all, we want to prevent muscle breakdown. And the next role, which is very closely related, is to provide building blocks to build new muscle. And the idea is that, when possible, we always want to have some source of amino acids available for the body to synthesize new muscle protein. Now, you might have heard some advice from the bros on what exact meal composition you need to have before a workout. I'm going to simplify things and fall back onto my previous recommendation for meal timing, and that is you should have 4 to 6 equal protein feedings throughout the day, spaced 3 to 5 hours apart. This is based on a previous video I did that covered how many meals you should be eating per day. But the point I want to stress here is that as long as your meals are spread out about 3 to 5 hours apart, you're probably maximizing your protein synthesis. And this applies to the peri-workout window. So let's say you eat your pre-workout meal at 12. You don't need to eat again until 5 p.m. and you can work out anytime in that window. Now, a practical point I want to touch on is that whole food protein sources can be heavy on digestion. I think that for a lot of people, slamming a piece of chicken just before going into the gym isn't going to go over well. So when choosing your protein source, you should be thinking about how close you are to the workout to make your decision. Obviously, the closer you are to the workout, the faster digesting protein source you want to look at. If you're tight on time, whey protein is probably going to be your quickest digesting source. And since you want to be having some sort of protein about at least every 5 hours, say your workout's 1 to 2 hours in length, you should be aiming to eat 0 to 3 hours before training. Okay, let's move on to our next nutrient, which is carbohydrates. Now, carbohydrates are going to be a primary fuel source for training. The nice thing about carbs is that there are a lot of flexible options. For the most part, I would suggest having a whole food source of carbs. In the special case where you're really tight on time and you need to have something just before working out, you might consider having a very simple, more sugary source of carbs, like fruit juice. On the topic of carbs, I want to stress that large amounts of carbohydrates are not crucial for us as bodybuilders. You'll hear a lot of athletes talking about topping up their glycogen stores, but the truth is, on the grand scale of things, weight training is not very energy intensive. So unless you're already in a depleted state, you shouldn't have to worry too much about running out of glycogen. Now, there are some studies that have shown pre-workout carbs to be beneficial. A lot of this data is based on very intense endurance sports or in people who are already in very depleted states. So remember that it's not the end of the world if you can't fit in a large carb bolus before your workout. Moving on, the next nutrient we're going to talk about are fats. Now, the role of fats is to provide an energy source to us for training. Now, since we just came from carbs, I'm going to mention that I don't worry too much about the exact breakdown between carbs and fats, since both are used as an energy source. However, the practical limitation of fats are that they're very slow digesting. So if you have them just before your workout, you might run into digestive issues. My general recommendation is to avoid these if you're less than 3 hours before training. Now, the last nutrient I want to touch on is fiber. Now, while it's important to have sources of fiber throughout your day, it's not helpful for training. But I do want to discuss it here because it slows down digestion and it's something you should consider for practical reasons. You want to avoid really high fiber food sources if you're less than 3 hours before training. All right, so now let's put together everything we've talked about so far to give you my recommendations. I'll start this off by saying what you actually have in your pre-workout meal depends a lot on personal preference and your own nutrient requirements for the day. This is really something you're gonna have to test out over time, and you wanna find something that allows you to perform the best in the gym. I did say earlier that when thinking about carbs, you're probably not gonna run out of glycogen, and so a large amount of carbs isn't necessary. However, a lot of people do find that they perform better with some carbs in their pre-workout meal. As a general rule, you should be aiming to eat a pre-workout meal 0 to 3 hours before training. This will make sure you optimize your protein timing so that you always have amino acids available, and it can help provide energy to fuel training. You should include a protein source in a portion that's equal to your usual meals. As you recall from my protein video, my current recommendation is 0.82 to 1.0 grams of protein per pound of body weight per day. Let's say you weigh 200 pounds and you aim for 200 grams of protein per day. If you're aiming for 5 meals a day, you should be trying to have about 40 grams of protein in each of those meals. So your pre-workout meal would just contain 40 grams of protein. Now, I pulled you guys on my YouTube community tab, and there seems to be a spread of when you guys eat before your workout. So let's go through some recommendations based on where your meal is timed. Starting off, if your pre-workout meal is 3 hours or more before training, you really don't have any restrictions. You can have a relatively large meal containing protein, carbs, and even fats and fiber. If your meal is 1 to 2 hours before training, I would aim for a medium-sized meal, and by medium, I just mean that the number of calories is going to be similar to your other meals. And in terms of composition, you want to be focusing on protein and carbs here. I think that for most people, this option here is the one that tends to be the most practical in terms of getting in your pre-workout nutrition, because it ensures that you have some protein that's going to last you throughout the peri-workout window. You'll have some carbs on board to fuel you for training, and you'll have enough time before for the food to process, so digestion doesn't become a big issue. If you're eating less than 3 hours before your workout, you probably want to avoid fats and fiber, because these are going to slow down digestion and are going to cause problems from a practical standpoint. Now, the last situation here is when you're going to eat something less than 1 hour before training. This is going to apply to people who might be under time constraints or who like to train first thing in the morning. In this case, I would suggest having a fast digesting source of protein like whey and some simple carbs. The amount of carbs you have in this situation is really going to depend on what you can tolerate. In terms of exact numbers here, I would suggest starting with 0 to half of your normal meal's portion of carbs. Some ideas for really simple sources of carbs would be fruit, rice cakes, or juice. If you have an approach to what you're going to eat pre-workout, regardless of how close to your workout you are, you'll be able to optimize muscle growth and have a maximally flexible schedule. Just to touch on troubleshooting with your pre-workout meal, if you find yourself having low energy or performance during your workout, you should think about increasing the carbs in your pre-workout meal. And if you've run into digestive issues in your workout, you could think about moving your meal farther back, reducing calories in the meal, just shrinking it in general, or choosing simpler foods. Foods that contain less fiber and less fat are simpler. Foods containing more sugar tend to be simpler, and liquids are more simple than whole food sources. That's all for now, guys. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit like and leave me a comment below. I'm really good about answering every single one of my comments, so you'll definitely hear back from me. Comment of the week is from Mohammed Aziz Anwar. On my interview with John Meadows last week, I actually asked you guys what I should be asking him on my YouTube community tab, and I actually used Mohammed's question in the interview. It's always good to see people who listen carefully to my content and pick up details like that. If you want to see how I actually program my nutrition around a busy schedule, check out my video where I filmed a full day of eating while bulking and working a busy 24-hour shift in the ICU. I show all of my meals and actually break down the macros for you so you can really see what's going on. If you haven't already, hit subscribe and make sure you turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. We'll see you next time.